Hello everybody, welcome to this next video on linear algebra. So till now what we have seen, that given a matrix A, or we have talked about a linear operator T from V to V, then we will consider the matrix representation of T with respect to any basis. Then we saw that this A or this operator is diagonalizable, if and only if there are n eigenvalues, in your field, and algebraic multiplicity of each eigenvalue is equal to its geometric multiplicity for each eigenvalue. So this is what we have seen till now. So it means that, so according to this, there are so many matrices which are not diagonalizable. And hence, linear operators which are not diagonalizable. Right, fine. Now, what we are going to do is, we'll look at a special case which is of real symmetric matrices, and we will prove that these matrices are always diagonalizable. We will prove that they are actually more than diagonalizable. We'll do that. Right, so now we are going to prove that real symmetric matrices, are always diagonalizable, and I'll tell you they are more than diagonalizable, and what do I mean by that? That will be explained in next video. Okay, so in this video, for proving this thing, we need certain results. And in this video, we are going to prove that eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are always real. Now, you will understand this. You see, given a matrix, I'll give you two examples. Right, so you have this matrix, say, here you have 0, 0. And here you have minus 1 and 1. This is one of the matrix, right? Okay, so for this matrix A, what is the characteristic equation? Determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. So you have minus lambda 1 minus 1 minus lambda equal to 0. So you have lambda square minus plus 1 equal to 0. So if your field is real, right, then it has no eigenvalues. You see, because this equation does not have any root as a real root. It has two roots which are complex roots, right? So when your field is R, when you are in R, no eigenvalues. Fine. And if your field is complex, then obviously, because it is an algebraically closed field, so note that if F is C, then because this is algebraically closed, what do you mean by algebraically closed? Means every polynomial of degree n will have n roots for sure. Algebraically closed. Then for sure, your characteristic equation will have n roots. So you don't have to worry there. So all we are talking about is when F is equal to R. So here I am saying that although when the entries of the matrix are real, you may land up to a case where eigenvalues are complex. Right. So we are saying that if your matrix is real symmetric, then for sure your eigenvalues will be real. So this is the result. I am going to prove that eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are real. Result is, eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are real. So let me prove this result. This is very simple to prove. So now you tell me, what do you mean by a real symmetric matrix? Symmetric matrix means transpose of the matrix is equal to A, and real means all the entries are real. It means that if I take conjugate of A, I'll get A. Conjugate means complex conjugate. So this is the meaning of symmetric. and this is the meaning of real. So this is what we are going to use it. Let lambda be an eigenvalue of A which is real symmetric. So we need to prove A is lambda is real. So we need to prove that lambda is real. Now when do you say that a number is real? If conjugate of a number is equal to itself, then that number is real. So we can say that we need to prove lambda is real, or we need to prove that lambda bar is equal to lambda. So this is what we want to prove. Now because lambda is an eigenvalue of A, it means that there exists x not equal to 0 such that Ax is equal to lambda x. So this is the meaning of eigenvalue, right? This is the meaning of saying that lambda is an eigenvalue of A. Now we want to prove that lambda bar is equal to lambda. So somehow you have to bring the concept of lambda bar, and you note this thing that if this is there, then I can take the conjugate also, not a problem. That will give you this. So you have A bar x bar is equal to lambda bar x bar. Okay, fine. And because A bar is A, that we can use. So you note this thing. Now consider, you will understand in a moment that why I am taking this lambda into x bar transpose x. Now what is this? This is an n cross 1 vector. This is a 1 cross n vector. So this is a number. This is 1 cross 1. So this I can write it as x bar transpose into lambda x, because this is a scalar. This can go inside x. So this is equal to, now lambda x is equal to ax. So I can write it as x bar transpose into ax. Right, now using the associativity, you can write it as x bar transpose into a into x. Right, now you can write it as a transpose x bar transpose. Right, so you should know that a b transpose is b transpose a transpose. So that is what I have used here. Now because a is symmetric, so a transpose is a. This is a x bar t x y, because a is symmetric, that is by a transpose is equal to a because of symmetry. Right, now also because a is real, so a bar is a, because a is real, so I can write it as a bar x bar transpose x. Now what is a bar x bar? You see here a bar x bar is lambda bar x bar. So this is lambda bar x bar transpose x. So this is lambda bar is a scalar. So this is x bar transpose x. On the left hand side you started with this. Now you understand why we have done so. Now you see what we get. We get lambda minus lambda bar x bar transpose x is equal to 0. Now this can be 0 only if x is 0. This is not equal to 0 as x is non-zero. This is what we have started with. Therefore, lambda minus lambda bar is 0. Therefore, lambda is equal to lambda bar. It means that lambda is real. So, we get that all the eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are real. So, you get that all the eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are real. Right, now you can take example. You can take one a 2 cross 2 example. Take it. So you have here, you take 1 2 2 1, or you can take 3 here. Right, so you can take A. So A transpose will be 1 2 2 3. So A, they are equal. Therefore, this is a symmetric matrix, real also. So determinant of A minus lambda I will be determinant of 1 minus lambda, 2, 2, 3 minus lambda equal to 0. So this is lambda minus 1, lambda minus 3, minus 4 equal to 0. So this is lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 3, minus 4 equal to 0. So this is lambda square minus 4 lambda minus 1 equal to 0. So you'll get lambda is equal to 4 plus minus b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So this is 4 plus minus 20 upon 2a. So this is 4 plus minus 2 root 5 upon 2. So you see, you get two eigenvalues, both are real, right? So these are the two eigenvalues, 2 plus root 5, 2 minus root 5. These both are real eigenvalues, both are real. Similarly, you can test for 3 cross 3, 4 cross 4, whatever is the size of your matrix, for sure you will get the real eigenvalues when you are starting with real symmetric matrices, right? Thank you for watching this video. In the next video, we will be proving that real symmetric matrices, they are always diagonalizable, and we'll see that they are actually orthogonally diagonalizable, and for that we should know what do we mean by orthogonal vectors. So that is what we are going to discuss in the next video. So please share this video and do subscribe to this YouTube channel. Also, in the description you have a link for Maths for All website. Do visit that link. There are so many things. We have around 30 quizzes for this linear algebra course. So please do those quizzes and get to know that how much you have progressed in this course. And please write in the comment section if you